Māori ora, the way I understand it, it's like an internal energy. So it's not necessarily something that you're just like, you're born here and then you have Māori, but it's more like, in a way, it's like connected to your wairuatanga energy, your vital energy. That's how I understand Māori, is that everything has a Māori and an essence. Our kaupapa is just tuning into that essence of yourself and acknowledging that, even if it's pōritanga, it could be harikoa, whatever that essence is that you're feeling into, expressing that and finding that place of balance.
Ko puhi kai ara ki te tangata, ko ngā tikimata whaurua te waka, ko emeeme, me taratara aku maunga, ko Ngāti Pakehi, me tahawai, me Ngāti Uru aku hapu. Anō reira, ko Ngaronoa Renata tōku ingoa.
Kia ora e te whānau, ko Komako Aroha tōku ingoa. Tēnei te mihi e rerenana ki a koutou.
Toro pai pai. hākina, hāputa. So Komako used the word balance, which is orua, to find the balance within Māori and have wellness doesn't necessarily happen immediately. You can come in quite unbalanced.
Yeah.
And that's a given. And if we're going to use kupu in that way as the words Māori order, what are we offering in terms of changing that to a state of orua will infuse us with wellness and hauora?
I te wā I te whakatangi o Komako I te kōaue I hoki o ki mahara no ki whakaro ki ngā mātua tīpuna I whawhai mō te reo me te whenua me ngā kura kaupapa. I quite an awk for cuddle. I felt more connected to Taonga Puoro.
At first, I felt like the hui was pulling my thoughts out of my head. And then it made me feel connected to Te Taha Wairua. Made me think of my nan, my papa, and also made me feel grounded. And the higher it went, the more I felt like I was getting lifted. I was like, so cool and good.
When Tawhiri Mātia, after Papa and Rangi were separated, Tawhiri Mātia was raging and, you know, very upset with the decision of the separation. Hine Putehue, Tawhiri's sister, wanted to āwhi the rage and the pain and embraced his sound within her and then breathed out her own oro, her own sound of peace. And what I really love about this story, so relatable to the winds, the internal winds that we experience as humans, so we're so swayed by the challenges of life. And this being a metaphor in my life has really helped me to embrace the practice and the energy that Hine Putehue has to offer us. The energy that I get is that there is like unlimited potential within what Hine Putehue offers us. Trust in your own intuition and your own mātauranga within your puku if you are feeling challenged in life.
Thank you.